majestic being of metal and magic glares at you from the cavern ahead. This inevitable is a Marut, one whose sole purpose is to destroy those who cheat death. A group of drow ambushers in the next room howls a battle cry. Hill's tribe must be determined to fight you and the inevitable at once. Your nostrils. It is true. The trolls and drow are working together. As the gate grinds open, the drow scorpion screams a command. An answering chorus of shrieks of inevitable's footsteps thunder across a stone bridge ahead. Several drow flee ahead of it in terror. Caught up with the inevitable, it stares coldly at you, calculating the threat posed to its mission. You stand amidst a scene of terrible slaughter. The inevitable has already passed this way. You see signs of ancient architecture in the halls ahead. Vale's tribe must be living in the ruins of an older civilization. stalks down the hall to your right, relentlessly focused on its target. The locked gate ahead marks the outer boundaries of the drow encampment. You have entered a new section of the caves. In the distance, you have never heard of a beholder serving a drow, or anyone else. You shudder to imagine the bargain that they must have struck. Clusters of giant mushrooms grow more sparse as you emerge from the beholder's domain. Ahead, torrents of water plunge into a pool far below. If you leap into the waterfall, there will be no turning back.
Ahead, three
champions of Vale's forces have arrayed themselves for a last defense. This great hall is flanked by towering statues from a lost age. Vale chose a dramatic battleground for her last stand against the inevitable. Marut, and saved the Vampirus from her doom. Vale shouts in triumph.